Okay, welcome class. This is 7th day of June 2017. I'm reaching you from Accra and you are in different locations in Lagos. So the major thrust of today's lesson and seminar is on interrupts. And as we have agreed, we're going to have Gbeleyi, you know, make his presentation, followed by, let me see who's next, by Busayo, then Jerry, then Solomon Abam. Now that this person is not here, Jerry will then take on Solomon Abba. The three of you will make the presentation. So let us begin with Gbeleyi. Gbeleyi, you have the floor to present on interrupts.
Good evening, everyone.
Yes, good evening to you.
My prayer today's class will not be interrupted by the network issues.
It has to be interrupted. But go on, I'm just joking. All right.
So let us quickly move to the third slide.
Third slide.
Everybody's on the third slide.
Yes, we are there.
My outlines are, which gives us the definition of interrupt. I'm going to do some addition to the topic on that slide. Interrupt simply means a signal. That's the central processing unit. And is usually generated when an input stroke output is required. For example, hardware interrupt.
Yep.
Is pressed or when a mouse is moved. Another example, software yes. interrupt can be generated by a program requiring disk input or output.
Yes.
Like, which is slide 4. Are we there?
Okay, slide 4, yes. How the interrupt works, yes.
So, from what we have on that slide and the diagram, we can see there, the CPU receives the interrupt signal. An exact copy of all of the registers in the CPU at that moment in time as stored in the stock in the primary memory, so that the CPU
state.
So this is just the exact way how the interrupts work on the system. So we'll move over to the next slide, which is slide 5.
Yes. Types of interrupts.
We are going to look at different types of interrupts, but I'm going to later categorize them on three broad types. The first one we have there is called interrupts or maskable. This one can be said to be hopefully useful for using when the computer needs to do something or more. I'll move over to the other one, which is called it's not included precedent and interrupt any task. You know? Like I said earlier, I said these various types that I'm giving, so I'm still going to categorize them under three broad types.
Okay.
Which is the internal interrupt, software interrupt, and external interrupt. So we'll now move over. Types, interrupt types continue. This time around, we are looking at asynchronous and synchronous. The asynchronous, this one I gave earlier about maskable, which is from the input or output device. This synchronous type, also called exceptions, the processor dictates exception or abstract,
okay.
or either from a programmed perception. So we are moving over to the next slide, which is processing interrupt. Can be triggered, and interrupt triggers a sequence of events to occur within a computer system. These events acknowledge the interrupt and perform the action necessary
Yeah.
If interrupt is enabled, interrupt is also serviced by software which is written by the user. It's called the handler. Essentially, it's subroutine. So, I'd like to just add some points to it, which is sequence of the events that takes place during the processing of interrupt. The first one is doing nothing until the current ordinary sequence get the address of the handler's routine, which is normally called vector interrupt only. The next one is to invoke the handler's routine until the current interrupt has been executed. This is just the process of how interrupts takes place in the system. But moving over to the next slide, which is common functions of interrupt.
Good.
Pictures, just because of my default one says interrupt transfer control to the interrupt service routine generally through the interrupt computer method in the address. Why the next interrupt service instruction? We'll move over to the next.
Yes, next.
Interrupts
are
there.
Yes, we are there.
There are different patterns of how interrupts are handled by different architectures or set. Like there is just different routine handle different interrupts called IS, that is interrupt service routine. The other option is when CPU is interrupted, it was doing and context is safe. A generic routine called interrupt handling routine is run, which examines the nature of the interrupt, called the correspondent IS. I can also further explain the process or manner in which the system programming an interrupt handler, which is also called in a microcontroller firewire, an operating system or a device driver whose execution is to trigger by the reception of the. I move over to the.
Yeah, that next slide, is it the one with the figure?
It's just a typical 11. Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
Are we all there?
We're there. Is that the one with the figure?
Yeah. With the diagram there.
Yes.
Yeah, 10. So that is just the process, a simple diagrammatic process of how interrupt takes place, the process of interrupt. The normal process is that. That is, you fetch, decode, and execute. But as a result of the interrupt, the decode is not found yet. So how you can see that diagram is the fetch cycle, the execute. Diagram below, you see the start. The fetch next, execute instruction. Then it will go back if there is an interrupt, which has been stored in the memory, which is sometimes called the on.
Yes.
Or where the memory has saved the interrupt. Go over to the next slide, which also talks about interrupt handling. I mentioned earlier that the processing system by some registers and program pattern determines which size of interrupts occur. As a result of my research, I was able to discover.
Yes.
Pulling and it, but I found a little difference between them, which I will later raise as one of my questions while going through this. So
okay, you have slide, two more minutes.
Hello.
Yes,
sir?
You have 2 more minutes. Go on.
Yes, I'm done, sir. I said the last slide.
Oh, the last slide is the reference. Okay, references, not reference. Okay, wonderful. Very well done. Very well done. We've had Bileyi present, and we need to now ask him a few questions. Solomon, what questions do you have for Bileyi? Jerry is disturbing us with his noise. Unfortunately, this I cannot let him off. Yeah, Solomon, questions for him? Okay, none so far. Yes, go ahead.
Interrupt. So, how can we, when we have the system working, we are working with the system and something occurs, how can we determine from a hardware interrupt? How do we do that? Okay.
No, just note that you are going to answer the questions all together. Busayo, yes. Any question?
What is the difference between an interrupt and an exception? An interrupt and an exception. The difference between.
Okay, interrupt and exception. That's it. Jeremiah. Any question for him? You are still busy with your noisy background. So, okay, let's yield to Bileyi. Bileyi, can you answer the two questions? The noise is coming from Jeremiah. It's much, I know. It's from Jeremiah. So, Bileyi, Bileyi, can you answer the other two questions? Okay, Bileyi, can you answer the two questions?
Sir, yes, the question from Abraham first, sir, talks about how do you identify software and hardware interrupt. The basic thing, based on my explanation, is that if the signal device, then that is an hardware interrupt. But if the signal is from the internal, that is, if the interrupt are those,
yes,
system, for example, while you are processing some instructions and when we want to execute one more application program, such is called to boost your ask, how do you know whether it's an exceptional interrupt? And anything that is exceptional is as an interrupt, I will explain it as executing a program is called an exception. For example, while executing a program, if we got a value which should be divided by zero, it's called an exception. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Let me ask my question. Actually, one observation and one other question. Now, the observation is that on two of your slides, you will find the footer of some other author. I don't know whether you reference him at the bottom of the footer. So I think the best thing to do is to take off that footer. If you just check some of your slides, you find that you have some footers which indicate the original author of that particular, of one or two of your slides. So you need to take care of that so that you can put them. Reference that person. Now, when you talk about interrupts, and you talk about, it's actually another component of multitasking of the computer. Something comes in, and you ask that person to ask that operation to hold on a minute, and then you process this one. It's on queue and all of that. Now, what, Bileyi, do you see as the difference in how? Processors, the older version processors and the modern day processors handle interrupts. Yes, answer quickly. Bileyi, did you hear me? Yes.
Hello.
Yes, okay. That's the question. Yes, please answer quickly.
The modern day processors have been upgraded with the recent architecture.
Good.
Handlers to take care of more interrupts than the former or the older generation interrupt. For example, the olden days architecture does not have series.
Yes.
This, what I mean by arrows is request. For example, the modern days processors of Intel board, they have up to IRQ 0 to IRQ 15.
Good.
Meaning that that comes up, the system will be able to handle it. But in the olden days, processors, they have minimum, probably maybe one or two.
Yeah.
So that is the little difference I can report, sir.
Wonderful. That's very good. Now, let's move on quickly because we're going to stop this class in an hour. So I've listed Busayo as the next to present. Busayo, you have the floor. Okay, carry on, Busayo. Say we should go to slide what?
Slide four.
Okay, why slide four? Yes.
Now,
yes, we're there.
Interrupt is the signal to the processor emitted by the hardware or software, indicating an event needs immediate attention. Now, whenever an interrupt occurs, the control
speaks better English. So occurs.
The controller completes the execution of the current instruction and start execution of an interrupt handler. Five. Now, what happens when interrupt occurs? And these are the things that occur, the sequence of events that occurs when an interrupt happens in the processor.
Very
now,
good.
The current program counter is.
Yes.
Then the interrupts are blocked when that happens. Now, if it's either a timer or an external interrupt, the register holding it as at that time is totally cleared.
Okay.
And then the program execution handler. Then it is a function of the interrupt handler to now execute it. Now let's quickly move to slide six.
Sure.
Where I have types of interrupt. Now I have here the now the hardware interrupt is further divided to interrupt and a non-maskable interrupt. Now, we also have different categories of software. They are just basically two. We have the normal interrupts and
okay.
Interrupts. Now, the hardware interrupt is a signal sent to the processor from an external device. For instance, like a DIX controller or an external peripheral.
Yes.
When we press, like what my colleague said the other time, that when we press key on the keyboard, move the mouse. These things actually trigger what we call the hardware interrupt, which causes the processor to read.
Yes.
We have the software interrupt. Now, the software interrupt can also be classified into a normal interrupt and a session. A normal interrupt usually is caused by the software instructions. That's actually what causes the normal interrupt. But the exception. An exception is just like what my colleague said, that's an unplanned interrupt while executing a program. For overflow causes an exception. When I say arithmetic overflow, I mean when a particular arithmetic operation is being performed, the result that comes from it, if it cannot be accommodated in memory, that actually triggers an undefined instruction. When an instruction is undefined, it triggers an exception. And when there's a syscall, it also triggers an exception. Now, let's go to...
Yeah, the slide on normal interrupts.
Yeah, I'm done with the exception. So let's move to slide 12, where I have the interrupt handling. Now, what's an interrupt? Now, the function of the handler is operates instruction, which sources and saves its configuration in a register.
Yes.
In the register, it knows the parameter of the parameter, which is we have from X like that. I have first level interrupt handler. What is this first level interrupt handler? That is the source of the interrupt. And after that, it initiates the service of the interrupt. That is called first level interrupt handler.
Okay.
Now I have my second level interrupt handler. Now the second level interrupt handler is a soft interrupt handler that slows the interrupt handler. These interrupt handlers are like, what do I mean by this second level handler? The second level handler, they are longer lived than the first level interrupt handler, and they are just normally executed.
Yes.
The kernel program. Now the kernel program is just like what controls everything in the system. It's the first program loaded on the start and the rest.
Okay, you have 2 more minutes.
As the first level and second level. Now, let me quickly respond to the question Prof asked. How does the process do this? Now, I think from my own understanding, sir,
yes,
all processes and interrupts. Now the operating system has another platform that calls the scheduler, apart from the queue. The scheduler figures out
the
program to control the that demands is much. Now that's just for my own understanding. That's just how the process
operates. Okay. Very good, very good. Thank you. So we're going to applaud both Bele Yi and Busayo together. Thank you very much. So let's look at Solomon. Solomon, before Solomon, let's take questions for Busayo. You can see he has given us another perspective, although areas of overlap are there with what Bele Yi gave us. Bele Yi did very well, and Busayo also did very well. So, question, Bele Yi, for Busayo.
Mr. Busayo, well done. Please, I don't know if you can give us more explanation on what you gave in terms of second, your last slide.
Second internet and interrupt handler.
Hello?
Yes, yes, we can hear you.
Second level interrupt handler. Yes.
Well, just hang on. I thought he explained it though, but just hang on. Solomon, question for Busayo. Okay, none. So, Busayo, answer that question.
Now, like I said, the second level interrupt handler, they are soft interrupt handler.
Please go on, Busayo. Solomon is not ready, so go ahead, yeah.
And they are longer lived than the first level interrupt handler. They are just normally the second level interrupt handler, the kernel program. That's why I further explained the meaning of kernel program. It is the kernel program that handles the second level interrupt handler.
Okay. Yeah, that's very good. As I said, I don't have any question for you at the moment. Because the two presentations, address, the key areas, the key issues in interrupts. So let's go to Solomon very quickly. Solomon, are you there? Solomon. Well, that has brought us to the end of this class. We've listened to Bele Yi and Busayo on interrupts, and they have made very good presentations. Now, the other members of the class will look forward to your presenting tomorrow. I think we'll have a class tomorrow, not so?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's fine. So, until tomorrow then, exactly 8 o'clock, wish you a very fine evening. Thank you very much. And good night, all. Good night to all.
Hello, sir. We're having no class tomorrow, sir. On the night, it's the next day.
Okay, tomorrow... Okay.
Class on the 9th, okay,
we have it on the 9th. Okay, that's fine. 9th, let me see what I'm going to make 8 o'clock. Yeah, I think I can. Because I'll be back in Nigeria and we can handle that. Okay. So, classes are adjourned till Friday. And Bele Yi, as the class captain, please let the others know that they have several arrears of materials to present. So until tomorrow, do I say good night to all?
Okay, sir. Bye-bye. Thank you, sir.
Good night. Thank you very much, and God bless you all.